Gallery Landsberg stars in Thank God It's Friday. Tonight at 11:30 on Great Movies. Right now, stay tuned for the Eyes of Toronto. City Pulse Tonight with Martineau and Ruskowski is next. Highway number 8 between Cambridge and Hamilton. From Don Mills in Overly, this is City TV everywhere. Tonight, the new hooker law is working.
Tonight, Calgary stampede crash.
Tonight, the Jays against the A's.
Show me the pictures.
Where do you begin the evacuation?
More warm weather in the forecast.
10-4-20, what's your ETA?
Glenn, we've just arrived.
Good evening. Our top story tonight, Metro Police cracking down on street prostitution. Last summer, Toronto streets were crowded with hookers because legislation police used to charge them was struck down by a court ruling. Parliament has now given police a new law, which they say is doing the trick. We have more tonight from our crime specialist, Mark Dailey, with the City Pulse Live Eye. Mark?
Thanks, Ann. In fact, last year it was open season out here for prostitutes and their clients, and the regular track areas downtown and here in the Near East End became so congested that the prostitutes spread out to new turf in the West End. The new Section 195 of the Criminal Code that recently was enacted has given police the legal weapon they were begging for.
Police feel the new law governing prostitutes communicating for the purpose of engaging sex has cut the number of working girls more than in half.
On a warm night like tonight, we could drive around and count between 300 and 400 girls on the street, and now we drive around, we probably count maybe 100, 150 at the most.
There you go.
The morality squad has more manpower and money now, focusing on getting the rest of the juvenile hookers back home. But it means meeting more of the ladies in general and charging more of them, too.
We drive around and we'll pull up in the car or walk up near to where the girls are standing that we suspect are plying their trade as a prostitutes, and they will come over and, of course, communicate for the purpose of engaging in prostitution, and we'll charge them that way.
Female officers posing as prostitutes do the same job on the Johns. Police say they'd like to shrink the expanded areas, like the Lakeshore Motel Strip in Queen West. All they need is time and money and hope the new law holds up in court. But Sergeant Breyer says so far they have given the streets back to the law-abiding people.
10 or 11 is a prime time at night for them. But we'd come down at this time of night and there'd be 15 girls over there around that corner of Pembroke, between there and about halfway down the block. And it was always four or five in this corner. As you can see, they're not there anymore.
I should add that His Honor Judge Bernhardt in the provincial court has made a decision which challenges the validity of this law, but it's before the Court of Appeal, and we expect a decision on that in a couple of weeks, Ann.
Mark, we hear an awful lot about how the law affects female hookers, but is this law as effective against male hustlers?
It is. They can use it the same way, but police have always they stay away from the Track 2 area, mainly because it's not a residential area. They don't cause a lot of problems for the neighborhood, and the police say they just don't get the complaints there. They keep an eye on it because there are more robberies and rough stuff in that neighborhood, but the law can be used there. You just haven't really used it a lot yet.
Okay, Mark. Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
Yorkville merchants meeting tonight, planning ways to convince York, City Hall to limit street vendors in the Yorkville area.
Has made application from City Hall. I'm sure it has worked against them. Have good quality merchandise, do not have shabby display stands and things like that.